Hi everyone, it's Lindsay. Welcome back to another video. Today is my very first video for the Not Too Shabby Design Team. I am going to be sharing with you how to color with colored pencils in OMS, or as many card makers know it, GAMSA. Now, GAMSA is just a brand name of OMS, Odorless Mineral Spirits. What I am using today is something I bought when I first started crafting 11 years ago. This is a very large jug of odorless mineral spirits. Essentially what it is a very mild paint thinner, I would call it. It says it's odorless. I have really bad migraines and smells get to me like no other. This does not get to me. However, you do want to use this in a well-ventilated area. Have a window open, don't do it in a small space with your door closed, that kind of thing. Make sure that you have a good amount of air circulation in the room you are working with. Now, like I said, I've had this bottle since I first started crafting. When I bought this, I needed something small to put it in, and I have this little dappin dish on hand. What this is essentially for nail artists or your nail techs out there. I went to cosmetology school once upon a time, and this is what you put your liquid in when you're doing acrylics. So I have this on hand. It's what I use to hold my OMS while I am working. And I use a little plastic pipette to transfer it from the jug to my little dappin dish. For the blending, I use paper blending stumps. There are several different kinds. I have two here. I have the double-ended that are more solid, and then I have the single-ended that have a hollow center to them. I prefer the double-ended ones that are the solid paper blending stumps. They do a better job for me. And to clean them off from the color is very easy. I use a sanding block. You can find these very cheaply on Amazon. A nail file also works. Or you can get one that is for like professional artists. That works too. I just like the blending block or the nail sanding blocks because they're super cheap. And because I have a lot of different grits on there, I use it on my cards as well for getting rid of little ink splotches and things like that too. Another thing that you will need is a pencil sharpener. Now, most artists say don't use an electric pencil sharpener, use your handheld ones. I'm not a real artist, I would say, so I use my electric pencil sharpener because I like the fine point I can get with it and because it saves me a lot of time and a lot of twisting with my hands. It's what I like to use, so I'll leave it linked down below. For the stamp set for my cards today, I'm using this My Favorite Things set. It's called Wonderful Woodland Friends. I'm also using the coordinating die set to do some stamping and die cutting today. This is from the Not Too Shabby Stamp Shop. And I do have a coupon code for you to use at the Not Too Shabby Stamp Shop for 10% off your order. That coupon code will be down in the description box below, as well as a link to take you directly over to the shop to do some shopping. Just enter that code in the coupon code area when you're checking out for 10% off your order. Now, the first thing I want to show you before I even start coloring is a little trick to do some stamping on your die cuts. Now, most of the time, if I'm doing just simple die cutting and stamping on those die cuts, I will just cut out the die cut from some white cardstock and then line it up and stamp onto the die cut. However, when I am doing a lot of different cards like this and I'm using some intricate die cuts like this tree where I need to line up all those little leaves, I like to use this technique. I keep this little paper in my pouch with my stamp set, but first what I do is I take that cardstock and I'm going to die cut it with all the dies from the set. You can just do a few if you want, or you can do all of them like I'm doing here. Then you have kind of a template for any time you use the stamp and die set together. So I'm going to line these up on this piece of cardstock. I suggest using a cardstock for this so you have a nice bridge where your stamp is going to sit, almost like a little ledge. So the thicker the cardstock, the better. I'm using 110-pound cardstock here. I lined up all of those dies on that paper, giving a good space between each one of them. That's just going to ensure that if I use multiple stamps at one time, the stamps are going to have enough space in between each of them so they won't bump into each other and affect the stamping. I'll go ahead and run this through my die cutting machine. I can save those die cuts, but what I'm really looking for right here is the outline. I want to save the outline of all those stamps and just remove all those die cuts. And you only need to do this once. Once you have it all cut, you're good to go for any time you use this die and stamp set together. So once I have those all out, I'm going to go ahead and insert this into my Misti. You can use any stamp positioner. I just love the Misti. You can use a mini for this technique as well, as long as your paper fits inside the mini Misti area. Once I have that inserted, I'm going to make sure that it's held down by a magnet. You can also use some removable adhesive on the back. And then I'll take the stamp that I want to stamp. In this case, I'm using that tree from the Wonderful Woodland stamp set. I'll line it up right in that area where the tree has been die cut. Now that little lip that the die cut gives you won't let you move that stamp outside the area. Then you can look straight through and line it up, making sure it's even on all the sides. When you're ready to stamp, you can insert your die cut into that opening. It'll fit like a little puzzle piece and it's not going to go anywhere. You can put removable adhesive on the back, but because you're using your Misti, because it's lined up in the corner and your die is inserted in that paper, if you miss stamp, or if you won't miss stamp with the Misti, but if your paper moves after you stamp it, then you can go ahead and just insert it right back into the opening and it will stamp on top of it again. This is going to give you the best results for stamping on your die cuts and making sure they're lined up perfectly each and every time. This is a great technique to use if you're stamping multiple images across multiple cards. So if you're making a card set or something like that, this is a great technique to use. I did that for all of my stamps and now it's time to get coloring. The first coloring or colored pencil that I want to show you today are just your regular Crayola cheap colored pencils or your Crazy Art colored pencils. This is what I learned this technique with. When I first started card making 11 years ago, my husband and I had just had a new baby. We didn't have really any extra money. So all of my supplies were bought very, very cheaply with what I could afford at the time. That was these pencils, and that's what I started with, and they work great. The one thing with this particular pencil is that they have a lot of filler in them, so there isn't a ton of pigment, but it's actually great if you want to go for that very light colored look, which I happen to love. One downside to using these pencils is that you don't have blending options really for these kinds of colored pencils. Whereas the other pencils I will show you have kind of that light, medium, dark color situation in those sets. For the Crayolas and the Crazy Arts, you really don't get that. However, you can make do with what you have, and with this technique, you really don't need it if you don't want it. So what I like to do is take a pencil and lay down my initial color. You don't want a super hard hand here. Make sure you have a nice sharp point and just very lightly color in your pencil. Then use your blending stump, dip it into your OMS, and then just blend with that blending stump and the OMS on there. You want to make sure you have enough of that liquid into the blending stump to do blending. You'll notice when you run dry, because it will start to feel kind of scratchy on the paper as that liquid goes. The wax won't blend as smoothly. So if you feel like it's too light, you can always go back in and add layer upon layer upon layer. With the OMS, you're blending out that wax each time. So especially with your wax-based pencils, you won't get that wax bloom with this, or you can add many more layers before you do get that. So here I'm adding a few layers right down at the bottom where that point is on the heart, and then blending up towards the little humps on the heart, for lack of a better term. Once I have that blended out once and I want to add more color, I add it right back to where I want the color the darkest, and then I can blend out again. This is a great way to use these pencils, and you just layer them up until you get the intensity that you want. With the OMS, you could layer these 10 times if you wanted to get that really intense color. Just know it's going to take a little bit more time with these since they aren't as pigmented. I'm going to go ahead and continue coloring this tree very quickly. I've sped it up. On the little circles in the tree, I'm going to go ahead and use a teal color. Again, for this tree with the cheaper colored pencils, I'll be using one color on each one of the little elements of this tree. So I'm placing the blue on just one side of the little circle, and then I'll use my blending stump and I'll just blend that out. Now, as you'll notice, as I'm coloring the different elements on the tree, all of the elements are different sizes. What I like to do is whatever is my biggest element, I'll go ahead and use my bigger blending stumps for that. I like to reserve my smaller blending stumps for the smaller items that I'm blending. You can buy a few packages of these blending stumps where they come in all different sizes, and then you'll have a nice selection of the large blending stumps and also the small ones. I prefer the small ones, especially for fine details and for small die cuts like this. Now, once I had all of the little blue dots blended out, I'm going to come in and add some green to each one of the little leaves that's on the tree. Again, I'm keeping the color just to one side because that's going to be my darker area. Then as I blend this out, I immediately end up with more than one color. So you don't need those blending combinations with these cheaper coloring options. Just make do with what you have. And then I'll continue just to blend this out like I'm doing here. Now, once I had all of the little leaves blended out, it was time to work on my biggest area, which is the tree trunk. What I like to do is come in from my darkest points and add in the color there. Then I'll take a clean blending stump, or you can just scratch off, I guess, for lack of a better term, or sand off the color from a previously used one. And then I just come in and blend that out towards the lighter areas. And there I have a little colored image ready to go. Now I colored in all of my images for this first card very quickly with my Crayola and Crazy Art colored pencils. And there's a look at all of them. So I have that little owl I used browns on. I also used little browns on the hedgehog. I used some teals and corals on the snail, pinks, yellows, and greens for the flowers, and pink, teal, green, and brown for the tree. Now this card, I also went ahead and stamped out a background with stamps from that Woodland Friends stamp set. And I colored those in the same exact way with colors that I used on the little images that I put on this card. You can see I used some pinks, corals, teals, yellows for the little centers, and then green for the leaves as well. I went ahead and layered each one of those little stamps up. I only ended up using the owl, the tree, and the two little flowers. And then I die cut some pattern paper from an MFT set with an MFT grass die as well. I added all of those on top of a little white cardstock that I matted with craft and stamped a special delivery also from that Woodland Friends stamp set. I used VersaFine Claire and Nocturne for that, so I got a nice crisp image. I popped that up onto the card base that I did my stamping on, and that is the card. Now let's move on to my next colored pencil, which is a wax-based colored pencil. I love the Prismacolors. I splurged for these a few years ago, and you can tell by the way I use these or when you see my pencils, these are well loved. So I am using the 132 set, and this set retails for about $72. However, you can get a step up from this, which is a complete set of 150 pencils for about $89, or you can go down to just a set of 12. You can also buy these open stock, and the retail price of each individual pencil is $1.30, which I love. So you can see I've got some colors that I use less often. And then I've got my brown, which is wearing down very quickly. So I can just go and replace those two browns just by buying the individual pencils, which I love that option. I can also complete my set by buying those few colors that I didn't get with the 132 set if I see that I want to later on down the road. Now the way these work, they have numbers on the end and you just kind of match up the numbers for each pencil. So you can see, like I just showed, the pinks that I'm using here are in numerical order. They might be just a few skips in between each number, but it's pretty simple to figure out these color combinations. Once I have my colors picked out, I'm going to go ahead and start coloring on my little die cut tree. Again, I'm starting with the heart here. That's where I want to spend the most time. And I'm starting off with my darkest color. When I'm coloring with my colored pencils, I go one of two ways. I start with the darkest, and then I'll work towards the lightest, and then back towards the darkest again. Or I start with the lightest, then add my darkest, and then go to the medium and kind of blend between all three of them at that point. It's just about preference of how you want to color and finding what way you want to color with them. So experiment, play, and have fun. What I did with this is I started with the darkest, went to the medium, and then the lightest. Now you will notice as I'm working with these blend beautifully on their own without any OMS or Gamsol added to it. But you will get those lines in your coloring just from the regular kind of texture you get with colored pencils. And you're also going to get a buildup of wax. Whenever you add the OMS, you just dip your blending stump right into the solution and then color right over that pigment. It's going to blend all of those colors together. It's also going to get rid of that texture that you get when coloring with colored pencils, and it will smooth out that wax. It just creates this beautiful, seamless blend, and it's just, there's nothing like it. I love coloring with colored pencils, and these are by far my favorite to work with. So I'm just going to continue to color this next heart, again, starting with that darkest and putting it down where I want the darkest shadow on my hearts. Here I'm doing a little at the bottom and then up the left-hand side a tiny bit. Again, with this, you want to use a light hand. You don't need a lot. These are super pigmented. But also, if you press too hard, you're going to make indentations into your paper with the colored pencils. You won't be able to get rid of those no matter how much OMS you put onto it. You will never get rid of those indentations, and some of the pigment can get stuck in those indentations as well. So a super light hand, and just build up your layers if you want more intense color. That's the best way to go about doing it, and it is a little bit difficult to get the feel of it, especially when you're kind of an instant gratification person like me. But I promise, if you just use a light hand and work up your layers, that's going to give you the best results possible. So I went ahead and blended that out with my OMS, and now I'll speed up the coloring a little bit as I finish out this tree. I'm using the same pinks that I did on the first two hearts to finish this third one, and very, very quickly blending it out. Once you've blended out your little heart, if you feel like you need a little bit more of the lighter pink or even the darker pink like I'm doing here, you can add that in right over the OMS, even if it's still wet. So I'll come in and add this in just a little bit and then blend that out very, very quickly just to give this a little bit more depth in the finished product. So once I have that done, I'm going to move on to my browns. Again, I'm using a few different colors here. I used three colors on the heart. For the tree, I'm just going to use two different colors here and place those down darkest where I want it darkest, then come in and blend it out a little bit with the lighter color. I'll leave a little bit of white space because with these wax-based pencils, they have a lot of pigment in them, or these Prismacolor pencils, I should say, have a lot of pigment in them. That pigment will move with your OMS. So leave that little bit of white space, and that's going to give you the perfect highlighted area where you get that third color, and you don't even need three pencils to do this. You can use two or even one if you wanted to for very, very quick coloring. Again, for the leaves, I'm going to go ahead and take advantage of this color system and use two different colors here, a little bit darker towards the point of the leaf closest to the tree, and then I'll go ahead and use a lighter color and just blend that out. Some of these leaves are a little bit bigger than the others. On the ones that are bigger, I will add the two colors. On the smaller ones, I might not even bother because you won't be able to tell, so I'll just use one color of colored pencil. I'll come in now with my lighter green here. These are a pencil that I would say you definitely do want to do a swatch of, because sometimes the colors don't perform, don't lay down on the paper like they look in the lead or they look on the pencil shaft itself. So just go ahead and create a quick swatch sheet whenever you receive these. It will save you a very lot of time, and also just a lot of headache trying to decide what color combinations you want to use. Once I have all of my leaves blended out, it's time to fill in those little circle areas. For this, I'm just going to come in and very, very quickly lay down a full layer of color on each one of these circles. Like I said, the OMS does not have to be for blending. It can also be for just taking away those pencil marks. Now for this one, I had already used the pinks on this blending stump. So what I did was just re-wet that pigment that was already on there, scratched it off on a scratch piece of paper, and then I can go in and blend that lighter shade of pink without any trouble or that blending over the top of it. Now, with these wax paste pencils, you will notice that they put a layer over your stamping. So if you have any little images where you feel like you lost some of the depth of that black or you lost some of that color, just come in with, I'm using a Micron pen here. You can use a Copic multi-liner or just a black pen and go over those lines and they'll come right back to life. So here is a final look at that tree all colored in. I love this. I love my Prismacolor pencils. They're my favorite pencils to work with. And if you find that you buy the Crazy Art or the Crayola colored pencils and you find you like this method of coloring, then I would suggest splurging on these. But if you aren't sure what coloring medium is your favorite, or if you even like coloring, I would go with the Crazy Arts first. You're only out $7 if you find you don't like it. Now to finish this card off, I went ahead and used an oval die cut and created a quick ink blended scene on the back. I added those two colored images from the MFT Woodland Friends stamp set, added a few cloud die cuts at the top and also a flag banner at the bottom with a sentiment from the stamp set that says you're pretty great. Super simple on this one and very, very easy to do. Now my last colored pencil that I want to show you is an oil-based colored pencil. I do not have the most expensive set of oil-based colored pencils at all. These are super cheap. I bought them on Amazon. I'm not going to pronounce the name right now because I butcher it every time, but this is a set of 72. I will leave a link to them down below. You can buy far, far more expensive colored pencils that are oil-based than what I have here. The ones I'm using here retail for about $55 on Amazon, but a more expensive set of oil-based pencils will, the kind that crafters most often I feel like lean towards are the polychromos, so I'm just going off them. A set of 120 is $165, so it's a big price difference. These aren't the best, but they work really well for what I want to use them for. I have a review on these that I will leave linked down in the description box if you want to know more about these pencils. So again, these work kind of like the Prismacolors where they have a color number on the bottom and then you just kind of go in order like you would almost with Copics. It's a numbering system. It works really well for finding your colors. These are ones I would say that you definitely want to color swatch just because the color can be vastly different from what is shown on the end of the pencil and also in the lead itself. With these, I use them just like I do the wax base. However, they have a different texture to them and they give you a different result. These don't really smooth out with the OMS as much as the wax base do. You do lose some of that texture, but you almost gain a new texture from it and it blends beautifully. But they don't blend it as easily as the wax-based either, I will say. With these, you can see I dip in once with my OMS, come and blend out the colors, and then I let that sit for a second, dip my blending stump back into the OMS, and then blend again to get them to blend even further. These just play differently than your wax-based pencils. It's almost a feel thing that you have to feel to get what I'm saying. One thing I will say about these pencils that are oil-based, and I don't know if all oil-based pencils are like this, but with these that I am talking about, they do have a smell to them. It is a little bit stronger, and if I use these over a long period of time, it does get to me. So just keep that in mind if you're sensitive to smells. So I went ahead and used my two purples on my hearts, and then I came in with a lighter purple. And again, using that same technique I used on my last die-cut tree with the wax-based, I just went ahead and colored those little dots fully with that light-colored pencil. And then I'll just smooth out the texture with my OMS and my blending stump. So even if you want to use your colored pencils and just color in a image completely, by using that OMS and blending over those lines that you've colored, it will take away that texture and that colored pencil look for a nice smooth finish as well. Now for the little leaves, I'm going to use a couple greens here and just put down the color where I want it the darkest, and then use my blending stump along with the OMS to blend out, and then that'll give me a few different colors of green here on these leaves where I have a darker area and a lighter area. So, sorry about the light going out. My husband wanted to look outside and see the snow, if it was coming down and if he would need to snow blow in the morning. It was a whole thing. So he shut my light off, didn't realize I was filming. And then he did it just a few more times just to bother me. So anyway, back to the coloring. I'm going to go ahead and finish up the base of the tree. I am using a brown here, and I put down the darker color towards where I wanted it the darkest, and then lighter towards the top. If you don't have a few different colors, you can go in with a little bit of a heavier hand or a few more layers where you want it darker, and then a lighter hand or a few less layers where you want it lighter, and then blend out that way, and that will give you a few different tones as well. So I'll finish up blending the base of this tree, and there is my final tree. I love the way this one turned out. So here is a look at all of my little die cuts with my oil-based pencil. I also went ahead and colored a little rabbit, a flower, two flowers, and then also the snail. And here you can see the finished card, all of those little die cuts added to it. So I went ahead and added some grass from the MFT die set that I used before, and I used some patterned paper and then also some green paper with the Swiss dots on it in the back. I layered up those die cuts with the grass, and then I added a little note. That die cut down there on the bottom is from Lawn Fawn. You can find that in the Not Too Shabby stamp shop as well. And then onto that die cut, I added a flower on the right-hand side and then that little snail on the left-hand side to finish off that scene. I matted the scene with some craft card stock and added the entire thing to an A2 side folding card base. I should mention today, all my cards are on A2 card bases as well. So one final look at this card, and then I want to show you all of the different coloring options side by side to give you a nice comparison of what each one can do. So let's go ahead and take a look at those. On the left, I have my wax-based Prismacolored. Then I have my cheaper Crayola and Crazy Art pencils. And then I have my oil-based on the right-hand side. You can see each one gives you different results. They're all beautiful. It's just about the look you're going for and what you want to invest in your coloring supplies. If you've never tried coloring with colored pencils before and you want to give this a try, I would suggest starting off with your Crazy Art and Crayola colored pencils and then see if you like it. If you like coloring with colored pencils, then invest in a higher quality artist set and go from there. You won't regret it, and if you don't like it, you can still use your lower base colored pencils for coloring every now and then, and you're not out a ton of money. That is going to do it for me today. Don't forget that coupon code for the Not Too Shabby Stamp Shop down in the description box below. You'll also find a link to all the supplies I used today down there as well. Thanks for watching, and happy crafting, everyone.